Hello, everybody. I'm gonna give like a couple of minutes for people to join us. But please, in the meantime, like feel free to like unmute yourselves and like talk to one another. So I'm not the only one talking.
Hey, I have good news. Look at this.
What?
Yeah, it just arrived.
That's awesome. You look good.
Thank you. I'm gonna record some videos today with this new t-shirt.
Awesome. You got it in blue and also black, right?
Yeah. And the black one is that one.
That's sick. Do you
It's
have a white
high.
one from Rio? I thought you got a white one from Rio too.
I don't. I actually wanted the white one, but I
Oh
don't. You didn't give me, Pat.
no, well, not me. Jess was responsible for
I
the shirts.
just got a bag that I got from Meet Barcelona from Mary and Jess as well.
I have that different dress. I should be wearing it. I was about to do it.
You're about to do what?
I was about to wear like my purple, like defy the status quo, like t-shirt. Hey, Dorit.
Hey, everyone.
Right, and thanks to the
Yeah.
read. That thanks to the read. That it just arrived.
Oh,
I was holding the
cool.
surprise. I thought about like texting you, but I said no. Let's leave that for the meeting.
Yeah, cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I know that I own you. I owe you one colorful one, not orange. Promise.
Yeah, I was too ashamed to wear the orange one.
There's still like some people missing, so that's why I'm waiting for it.
There you go, half an AM also wearing
Ah,
the shirt.
We should make a live stream. Let's make a live stream on Instagram, like discussing about good dollar dressed like that.
Yeah, that's cool. Hey, Anna. I was saying like I'm giving like 2 more minutes because there's people still joining. So Raphael was showing how cool his new t-shirt is.
Oh, did he get his new t-shirt?
Yeah.
Oh, joy. Hey, Rachel. Hey, Lauren. Hey, Pablo. Good to see you guys. Oh, recording is already on.
Yeah,
Hot damn.
because I set it up like automatically. So it started with only me, like, hello.
Okay, great. So, Mary, do you want to send the agenda just into the chat?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. So here's the agenda for the meeting.
Thank you.
But have you heard about Tiago?
No, not today.
He doesn't give up, but he's not joining.
Let me message him.
Is he supposed to? He said he would.
Yeah, he said he would, and like, I mean, we're starting with him. That's why I'm waiting. But if not, we'll move things around.
Okay.
Also, I see like Mish is missing, and some other people who signed up for the call.
Well, everyone, I had a little bit of, I'll admit, I had a little bit of trouble finding the link to the call, so maybe they also just haven't found it yet. Let's send the Zoom link into a few channels. I'll do that right now.
Yeah.
And if not, yeah, Mary, I'm sure we can switch things around.
Yeah. Wait a minute. I'm gonna share the link.
Adaro, is it the sounds of the jungle is at your end? I'm not jungle, no. Kidding, but the birds and the nature, it's you?
I don't think so, no. Because...
The birds and the nature and the drill, or someone drilling something too. It's me, sorry.
Okay.
No, that's nice. Okay, let's see, like, Thiago like Jones, but let's kick this off, yeah?
Woohoo!
Hold on, I need to accept people to like join the call. Okay.
All right.
All right, I'm ready. So, hello everybody. Welcome to like June Community Call at Good Dollar. This is the first call we're doing on Zoom, so bear with me and to other people for this some difficulties that we may be having. I'm like unmuting people at the same time that I'm talking, so that's one of the things. We used to like host these calls on Discord, but as you all know, we're having so many like technical problems, so that's why we decided to try out like Zoom, and let's see how this goes. Let's see if we're going to continue on Zoom or we'll move to like another platform. So let's get this started. It was supposed to be started with Thiago, but Thiago, are you here? No. So let's start with like in the agenda, like Pat, do you have like any, I'm sorry, like it was gonna be Bertrand, who's also not here, so we're gonna wait for him as well. So Anna, can you start like introduction, like the UB pilot, so Lauren and Pablo?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Mary, for the intro. We've got some great guests here on the community call. We're gonna be talking about a few really exciting initiatives. Got guests here, both the Good Collective team, Lauren and Pablo, have been working to build out the conservation basic income project in Brazil, in Kenya. We're gonna kick the call off with them and let them present the work that they've been doing. And then we also have Rachel here from the Halo Fi team, who is, thank you for joining us, who's going to be talking about an upcoming campaign that we have with HaloFi that is going to enable people. It's actually going to be the launch of the first Save in Good Dollars campaign in partnership with HaloFi, where people are going to be able to earn rewards for saving in Good Dollar through the HaloFi dApp. So thank you so much for taking the time to join us this morning. And we can't wait to spend most of the time on the call with you. I see that Thiago just joined, which is awesome. Mr. Wonderful is here. So if we can just kick it, we normally kick these calls off with Thiago doing a quick intro to review the numbers from the past few weeks. And so Thiago, you've got the floor, and then we'll throw it back over to Lord and Pablo.
Okay, thanks for waiting. I don't know if these faces are here. Hello. Some technical issues. So just a quickly updated about the numbers and about the cello and about the fuse. I don't know if this bar is in front of the stuffs. I believe no. So in the dashboard, in the cello tab, we have our numbers from the cello network, the monthly active users, and the unique UBI claimers, the amount of transactions, and the value of the transactions. These dashboards you guys can see in the second tab of the mine dashboard. And here we have also a map of the users in all the seats. So you guys can go to this map and see if you find yourself and your city here. And if you are not here, you need to claim a little more. And a cool stuff I want to show is this comparison about both chains. The first line is the cello and the second line is the fuse. So here we have a comparison about the active users in cello and the active users in fuse. In fuse is a little less than this because this is showing the last 3 months and not the month. And cello is showing only the month. The total transactions in both chains. Yesterday we have a spike in cello. So this is the reason the number is far more higher than in fuse. The total transactions count in both chains, more in cello. The amount of good dollars you can claim in a week. So in the last week in cello, we deliver this amount of good dollars. And in the last week on fuse, we deliver this amount of good dollars. And this is changed all the time based on the who is claiming or not the good dollars in each chain. The amount of claims last week in cello and the amount of claims last week in fuse, and also the total UBI delivered in each chain. So this is a cool view about the chains separately. And I intend to put this in the My dashboard so anyone can follow with this. And we also put together all the information together, both chains deliver this, et cetera, et cetera.
Thiago, question. Second column, is that value in USD?
This, you mean? Weekly total transactions? Yes, is USD. This number increased a lot yesterday. I don't know if we pay the, I don't know what we did to this number increase a lot, but it was very close to this before yesterday.
It and could be, depends on which transaction you measure. So it could be we moved liquidity, for example, from Uniswap to Uniswap. So
maybe this can be the reason. But yesterday was around 8 or 10,000, if I remember. And then we have this spike. We need to check. Maybe I'm filter anything wrong also. This is a possibility.
No, I just wanted to know which currency we are using here. So it's USD.
What's
really interesting that we are distributing 1.1. This is also USD, right? Weekly UBI on fuse and transaction value over 5,000. So it supports that figure that we have on velocity of money, right, Anna?
Definitely interesting in terms of supporting a velocity of money theory, although I think we need to understand how we're measuring the transaction number a bit more accurately so that things like the moving liquidity doesn't get included in the other trading volume. Mm-hmm. I suspect that this number is a bit off in that read.
I agree.
Yeah, so... cool. I mean, Thiago, I would say that this really justifies like what we've been talking about with the direction where we want to take the data in, both in terms of understanding the peer-to-peer patterns and transactions. And also, you know, this is great data to facilitate the discussion regarding the UBI distribution across the chains and what we want to do with the protocol and bringing that conversation to the DAO. I actually think having an accurate understanding of the peer-to-peer transactions per chain is a really, really important input in terms of determining the efficacy of the UBI on each chain and how much and how people are actually using it. So this is a cool view. Thank you, Thiago. Any other trends from this week? Anything in terms of new countries or any other insights you wanted to share with us?
The countries is still the same. Basically, our top countries is still the top countries. And we can see in this cool heat map here where most of our users are. And Indonesia is still the first, followed by Nigeria, Vietnam, and Bangladesh. They are still our top countries.
Cool. So just a note for people who are, you know, new to the call, Tiago contributes by doing all of our different data analysis. He works with a range of different blockchain tools and also Web2 tools to understand who, you know, basically Good Dollar's distribution throughout the world. Oh, look at how cool this is. Like really, really high fidelity. When you click on that, what can you see?
Nothing.
I see.
It's just showing the cities. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So just to let everyone know that we actually have some pretty sophisticated data capabilities and the ability to interrogate data and where the users are, where growth is happening from, and always experimenting with tools. So this is my open call to everyone. If you ever have a question around how Good Dollar is working in your area, how many users have you had, how many users are in my community, how many people do I have around me that are using Good Dollar, anything at all, know that we have some tools and an ability to analyze those answers. And you can always send through business requests to any one of us at the team, and we'll do our best to get more intelligence that helps everyone do their own work better. So thank you, Tiago.
Okay, that's it.
Lauren?
Oh, just an observation. Zoom is far more better than Discord. I can hear everything. Nothing's broke.
Oh, I see some nodding heads as well. Oh, we've got like 25 people on the call. Awesome.
Yeah, we've got more people than on Discord too. So it's a win.
Okay. Yeah, maybe that's a sign.
Yeah, it is a sign.
Welcome to everyone who has recently joined. Lauren?
Right. I might need permission to share my screen. I'm going to talk us through. Can everybody see a pink screen?
Yeah.
Talking about blockchain. Okay, cool.
I see your Excel.
In Excel.
Oh, that's not good.
That's not what we want to see.
No. There we go.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, that would have been a totally different conversation. Thank you all so much for having me, and Pablo. I'm going to talk a little bit about the broader concept because it's maybe different than some of the things that you're used to thinking about or talking about on this call, and then talk a little bit about what we've been building with this Good Collective concept. So I'm going to take about 10 minutes. Keep me on time, Pat, Mary, Anna, if you need to like give me a sign, I'm looking right at you. Okay, cool. Hold on, let me get my screen set up. So this isn't a question, right? I think we all know, as you can see in Hadar's Earth ship that with crops that's keeping us safe away from the planet, climate change is a pressing issue and we need to mitigate it in order to like actually stay on the planet. And when we think about that, like a lot of us get overwhelmed and we think about like scorched earth, we think about the fact that the responsibility lies with governments, we have no control, large corporations are at fault. But actually, we don't need to be so doom and gloom because, first of all, nature is doing a fantastic job of keeping us on the planet and keeping the planet habitable. And also, there are about 1 billion people who around the planet are involved in agriculture, land stewardship, and other activities who are currently helping to preserve the planet and make it healthier for us to live on. The challenge right now is that we're not necessarily acknowledging or compensating them for this work. But what's really cool and what we know really well at Good Dollar is a lot of them now have access to digital technology, so we can reach them in ways that we couldn't before. So it's no longer excusable. And from an international perspective, it's no longer even a question that like local indigenous populations are the best position to steward landscapes and to help us continue to steward the planet and continue to make it habitable for future generations. So how do we find these people? They're really difficult to find. A lot of times they're really far away, living in hard to reach locations or in areas that are just out of the reach of large institutions that wanna be able to involve them in, for example, like ecological asset markets or give them specifically aid disbursements to help them to kind of help with their stewardship activities. And in the past, one of the biggest challenges has been actually getting money to them. So what's happened is you have an institution that wants to give money to people who are making a really big impact. And it's really difficult to tell where that money's going. It's going through a bunch of intermediaries who are taking off a piece. There's exchange rates that are taking off a piece. There's maybe local ministries that are taking off a piece. And what's the biggest problem is you actually don't even know in some cases how much of it is making it back to the individual that it's intended to go to. And what's also complicated is when money is dispersed, often the institution that's dispersing money wants to actually know what happened to it, who it went to, and what happened as a result. And the measurement of that is also problematic. So right now, for example, if we wanted to measure the ecological impact of somebody planting a tree, the process of doing that is them working through a very large, like long, expensive, laborious process with a bunch of consultants, a verification body, and then producing what's probably going to be a paper PDF report that is really difficult to turn into a report that actually makes it back to the people it needs to make it back to. We all know that these are the ways of the past and they are changing. So what's really exciting right now is that we have all of these digitally native technologies that make it so that we don't need to think about any of those measurement challenges anymore. And we know this really well. We actually don't need to worry about any of the financial barriers anymore because we can reach people directly through crypto wallets. So this is a really exciting moment because not only do we have all of the infrastructure to do it, but because a lot of us are building the infrastructure on public blockchain, we can kind of create these cycles whereby somebody does something and automatically, without the need for too much human intervention, they can be compensated for it. So we're reducing the intermediaries, the potential for money to go elsewhere, and the distance between somebody making an impact and them being compensated for that impact. And what's really cool, so we've been talking about a scenario in which somebody is stewarding a tree, but one of the partners that we'll talk about in a second is Dtrash. So the same kind of concept of being able to measure something, verify it, and compensate a person who's doing that activity works for a variety of different climate positive activities, like diversion of waste from landfills to upcycling and recycling. So this kind of premise is what sparked us to want to build Good Collective, which is a global platform which utilizes Good Dollar and a bunch of different platforms from our partner organizations to directly pay the people who are making climate action or who are beneficiaries for other reasons. And we'll talk about like the segmented UBI expansion in a second, Pat and Anna will talk about that. So I don't know if Sana's on the call. These are a little bit old, but what we're going to be doing, Hadar has just actually today told us that the smart contract, the kind of logic behind this for deploying payments is ready. So we're working with our two implementation partners, Sylvie and Dtrash, on actually creating this kind of full circle system in the coming weeks. And then we're building an application layer on top of it so that people can actually, in human readable language, understand what activity is being done and what payments are being deployed and to whom. So we're building a dApp. We've just put out a request for proposal. We're going through those proposals this week and we'll find a development team in the next couple of days to build this. It will look something like this. I've mentioned before our two project development partners. Sylvie is a stewardship platform that follows trees from being planted all the way through to becoming a seedling and being planted. So for reforestation efforts, and then also for tracking of kind of seed provenance. So saying this is a mother seed that came from this particular area in the forest, and now is like the parent to all of these different child seeds. And their purpose is to be able to value nature at the tree level. So trees are really important parts of ecosystems, but they're kind of one unit of accounting. And so we're able to build on top of their methodology to reward people who are taking these measurements and stewarding these trees. And Dtrash, I see Phil's on the call, diverts waste from landfills and other problematic waste streams into upcycling, recycling, reuse. And so they're actually, they've created a methodology whereby somebody can document that they're taking trash from what would be the landfill and bringing it to a facility in which it can be used in a more responsible way. So in both of these cases, it's an individual community member, land steward, farmer, who's doing something, measuring it at that moment, and that actual activity is verified and then they're getting paid for that activity. The pilot that we're doing with Dtrash is a little bit more manual. So we're working with Naduk, our community partner, to actually deploy those payments right now. But the plan is for it to eventually be part of this automated system. There's a lot of benefits that I'm not going to run through right now, but a lot of them really are for the broader community. So we did this. I think we all know that this is the potential of the technology is to do all these types of things, but the rest of the world doesn't. And outside of the Web3 community, making sure that there's a really clear value proposition for building things on public blockchains, building things in open and transparent ways to kind of really force some larger institutions that are deploying capital and building solutions to build in such a way that we actually know where the money is going to and can hold people more accountable to their climate impact. So the first step of what we're doing is the DAP, which I'd mentioned, and we're developing that MVP in the coming weeks. It has some limited functionality, but enough for you at least to see what's going on under the hood of these different transactions. And then we have some future functionality. This is really a jumping off point for other use cases for Good Dollar. And Pat, if you want to hop in and talk about those a little bit.
Yeah, sure thing. So as you know, if you heard the Good Dollar pitch, you know that we want to put money in the hands of the people. Right now we have a UBI distribution mechanism that divides our current UBI between everyone equally, but we know that there are people out there, there are projects that they need a little bit more of money. So the idea is that, for instance, through direct payments, we can take care of these cases that Lauren mentioned, but we also want to develop a different kind of distribution of funds, which we call segmented UBI, and it's related to the development of our identity contracts. So right now, our identity to be Good Dollar verified, you pass through a liveness and uniqueness check, which is a variable, right, that we define as Good Dollar verified. But we also want to add other variables to this identity system, such as gender or your location. And that will facilitate to drive funds to specific groups of people. Anna, do you want to talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, I'll just add on, which is that well, this is the initial development of the capability that will enable us to enable anyone to get money to particular people based off of who they are, where they are, what characteristics that they meet anywhere in the world through the Good Dollar infrastructure, if you will. We can imagine a range of different use cases where this could be useful, right? So we're building out this capability within the context of specific payments and a climate basic income is what Lauren's discussing here, how we're our conservation basic income, where we're actually rewarding individuals with direct payments for their climate support and their climate preservation activities. But we can imagine lots of different variations on these same features that enable us to get money to people at scale who, let's say, are the most in need. We hope to build out on this capability to run some initial pilots that are focused off of a women's UBI, right? So actually sending money directly to women. We have dreams of building out this functionality to support micro entrepreneurs as well, right? So an entrepreneur's UBI, knowing that entrepreneurs are those that the people that actually create economic, upward economic mobility in their own communities, right? And jobs for people around them. And so we're really, really proud and excited of not just what we're doing today in this pilot, which is great. And we'll get more into the specifics of that in a second, but I think we'll share more about the specifics of this pilot as the work happens on the ground. But this is the pre-work to, I'd say, the next generation of Good Dollar UBI, which is actually focused on enabling multiple types of deployments run by different types of organizations, donor organizations, or individuals that are eager to get money to people around the world and to do so in a digitally native, transparent way.
Cool. Before I hand over, I have to do an embarrassing shout out because the team has been so super awesome. Pat has shepherded us through, she's really made sure that the product stays true to what Good Dollar's mission is. Progress and Mary have really been helpful in onboarding, helping me and Pablo understand what the Ambassador Network's about. We're onboarding ambassadors that are embedded in rural and farming communities in Kenya right now. So that's really, really exciting from an expansion perspective. Pablo, who's on the lower left, might also be new to y'all. Pablo, if you want to wave. So he's been working with us and running our pilot with Dtrash. So he's daily talking to Nadook to help them figure out how to facilitate this kind of payment loop. And Sana obviously designed all the beautiful stuff you see. Hadar just hit us this morning. I'm sure that timing wasn't a surprise, with an amazing toolkit, which pretty much allows anybody who's a project developer working in the climate or impact space to plug into Good Collective. So kind of the final ask is if anyone has, I know that we've talked about this, Progress and I have talked about this in Nigeria, for example, if there's anyone who's working on climate or doing some of the things like Sylvie and Dtrash, please send them my way. Ideally, we will continue to work with different partners and help them understand how they can use this as another mechanism to get money to their stewards and the people that they're working with in their community.
Thank you, Lauren.
Thank you, Lauren. I don't know if anyone...
Also, very nice slides.
Yeah, very nice design. I don't know if anyone from the community has any questions. Also, I see Pablo on the call. So if there's anything you want to add, Pablo, from your experience like working with Neduc, most of them, like, we're familiar with Christiane, who is like the Brazilian lead ambassador. I'm sure you've been working closely with her as well.
Yes, it was actually very interesting to begin working with them and exploring this new initiative. They've been working with Dtrash for a couple of months before the pilot, but this is like a renewed energy over there, and it's very interesting working with them now.
Thank you, Asim. So Bertrand, I just saw that you joined the call like a little bit ago. So I know you have like a time restraint. So if you want to go ahead and like give us like the liquidity update.
So let me share the tab. Portion of the screen. Let's see.
For those of you guys who are new here, just while Bertrand pulls up the screen, Bertrand is shares an update whenever we meet on basically the Good Dollar liquidity, where Good Dollar is across DEXs, any current liquidity rewards pools or opportunities for people who want to provide liquidity. And so he updates the community on that in his section.
Thank you. Because I'm not used to sharing on Zoom. Does it work? You see something already? Or?
I'm just seeing like a black screen.
Although it says you started your screen sharing, so maybe it just needs 1 minute.
Yeah, that's if you can just show the I could spell it about the liquidity update. But yeah, so this time we had some move, some big move. So like we learned from Ubiswap that the Ubiswap V3 rating has been stopped by Ubiswap Router partner because of regulatory reason. So all our liquidity was not visible anymore, usable anymore into the Ubiswap UI. That's why we have moved our liquidity from Ubiswap V3 to Uniswap V3, still on Celo. All of this is about Celo. We have no update on another chain. Because we are focusing on Celo. So we are testing, now we have liquidity pools on the Uniswap V3 on Celo. And the good dApp will be updated to support Uniswap on Celo instead of Ubiswap to make it transparent to the good dollar user on good dApp. They will still continue to be able to swap on Celo without going to Uniswap or Ubiswap. And also we have started experimentation with Impact Market, which is also on Celo. And so we started a Uniswap V3 pool where the good dollar token is paired with the PAC token. And I've personally added some liquidity there to test. And then we'll have Celo to put much more liquidity on both token. And finally, yesterday, the new project Double on Celo has started liquidity rewards on the Celo mainnet. And I've already tested to deposit good dollar tokens there. The unique value of Well, the original feature of Double on Celo is that instead of having to provide both sides of liquidity, when it's a pair, you need to usually provide both sides, so the good dollar token and a capital token, so like CUSD or MCUSD, something that or CELO, that is a base token. Here you can just deposit. You just have to deposit your good dollar token, and this good dollar token will be used to deposit liquidity into Uniswap V2 for now. So, and by depositing liquidity, you are joining also the liquidity reward campaign, and you will get you can follow your rank and your reward or future reward on the website. We have tweeted about it yesterday. Double has tweeted about it yesterday. And I think we will share more detail after. And that's all for this time. I think that was pretty active.
Yep. Thank you, Bertrand. So new pools open on the Celo mainnet and new reward scheme through a new project that was just released in beta called Double. Just here's my daily reminder, which is that it's great to use your good dollars to experiment with all of these new tools, but all of these new protocols are obviously, you know, developed by third-party partners, and everyone needs to do your own research before using them. But there are some cool rewards pools up on this new Double protocol, and we've been tweeting about them. Bertrand is an amazing, amazing contributor in terms of teaching people how to deploy liquidity and understanding the rules of the game and working with LPs. He's taught a lot of people how to deploy liquidity for their first time in DEXs. And a lot of that conversation actually takes place in the Impact Investors Telegram group, which I will send the group out to now. That's where a lot of the liquidity providers who support the UBI ecosystem actually congregate and discuss. So we'll drop that in there in case any of the new entrants here want to get involved. I want to make sure that we get to Rachel and we get the mods get an opportunity to present their proposal. So does that sound good to you, Mary?
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say next. Let's go with Rachel. I know Pat. I don't know if she just joined. Like, is it Pat in
the call? Rachel, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
Hi, can you hear me?
Perfectly.
Okay.
We
cool.
Have Zoom.
Cool. Awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much for having me on the community call today. I'm gonna just share a screen. Hopefully, I'll get the right one. I've got a quick presentation just to give you a bit of context around like what HaloFi is, what the goal is, and what we're kind of doing. And then I'm going to do a quick demo of using the HaloFi app with Celo, and then talk about like our partnership that's coming up as well. So can you see a Canva screen right now? Cool. Awesome.
Yeah.
I will just hit present. So grow your wealth with HaloFi, what we do. So the problem that we are tackling is, you know, saving regularly can be hard. I know this very much myself from my own experience. Like towards the end of the month, all of my good intentions sometimes go out of the door, and I've spent too much on flights and meals out, for example. So it's kind of, yeah, hard to hold yourself accountable. That's where HaloFi comes in. We help you save regularly with crypto challenges. So these are challenges that ask you to make deposits, you know, either weekly, monthly, or hold tokens for a duration of time. We've even done daily ones, but that's kind of quite a commitment to make those daily deposits. So each challenge, you'll have a goal to make regular deposits within it. So I'll just talk you through sort of at a high level, like how our smart contracts work. Bear with me one second. I just need to move this Zoom thing out of the way. So you can actually go and check out the challenges we have live right now by scanning that QR code or just going to app.halofi.me in the browser. And you're going to see a bunch of different challenges that are available. We're on Celo and we're on Polygon. So we have challenges for stable tokens on both of those chains. We also have challenges for Celo, et cetera. Challenges that require weekly deposits, monthly deposits, and challenges that require you to hold. So you can browse them, pick a challenge that suits you, or you know, when the good dollar challenge is live, you can join the good dollar one straight. Make the deposits that that challenge requires. So it could be the weekly deposits, could be the monthly deposits. Whatever your first deposit will be the deposit amount that you need to make subsequent after that. So if I deposit one CUSD per week, then I need to make that for the rest of the challenge deposits. Complete the challenge. So each challenge has a fixed number of deposits that you need to make. I think we will be going live with the good dollar with three deposits weekly, but that can depend, that, that can be varied, that can change with each challenge that we deploy. And then at the end, hopefully you are able to make all of those deposits and you're able to get the extra rewards that either come via incentives, or if we're, you know, also working with a yield bearing source, then there can be some DeFi incentives from that as well. If you did miss a deposit, it is designed that if you wait to the end, you will always get back your principal. There'll be no no fee for that. It will just be you kind of forgo your interest. With Good Dollar, we're actually going to allow users to withdraw at any point without getting an early withdrawal fee. So I'm actually just going to show you what HaloFi looks like at the moment with a with one of our Celo bi-weekly challenges. So let me know if you can't see this on Zoom, just give me a shout out because I've hidden the visual profiles on Zoom. But assuming you can go to halofi.app.halofi.me and you can see one of our challenges. So this one is a challenge that asked for Celo deposits and it asked for deposits bi-weekly, so every 2 weeks. So we can see two deposits every 14 days. In this one, you can deposit up to 50,000 Celo. You can deposit amounts much smaller than that. And I will show you that now. There's a GG score, which is basically our gamified score that will be proportional to how much you deposit. And then we can see the APY of the challenge, how much it's earned, and how much has been deposited, and then also the number of deposits that we are at. So this one is open, we're on the first one. You can also dive into this, so you've got a timeline. This is quite handy to see kind of all of the deposits that you need to make. So here you need to make one deposit before the 28th of June, and then another one before the 12th of July, and then there's like a waiting round here. And then after the 26th of July, you can actually withdraw your funds as a winner. You can add this into Google as well to get reminders. You can have a look here at all of the players who are in the game. So you can see who's part of that. There's some fun attributes like halos that change color, different kind of avatars that you can get. You can dive into more of that into the dashboard. But here we can see there's 234 players in the challenge. And then if you really want to, you can dive into the back end and you can see like the smart contract, the strategy, the tokens, and all of the pool settings, including like, you know, if there's any early withdrawal fee, if there's a performance fee, and what blockchain it's on. So with that all in mind, I'm gonna just click to connect my wallet. We're using the Rainbow Kit WAGMI connection, and we're actually working on the update for that now because they know there's a fix that needs to be made in the next week. Our dev team are on that. I'm gonna connect to MetaMask so I can see my wallet is connected up here. Join a challenge. So in this one, it's a challenge that's gonna ask me to deposit Celo every 14 days twice. I'm gonna choose, just for the demo, I'm gonna choose kind of a small amount of Celo. Just agreed to our terms and conditions. Approve that. And then I don't think you can see my MetaMask, but I am just approving that in my wallet. It will take a little bit of time because this is, you know, a live demo of on-chain Celo activity. But once it's been processed, we'll be able to, once we've approved it, we'll be able to then do the final confirm. And then I will be in the challenge. So again, it's going to take a little bit of time to process that transaction. And once it is, I'll be in there And then in 2 weeks' time, I'll need to come back and make another deposit. And probably you might want to pick, okay, cool, well, we can see it. I'm in the challenge. Awesome. Come back in 6 days to make my next deposit. That's when it's going to open for the next round. And it will hold me accountable to make those deposits in the Celo challenge. But of course, the exciting thing that we have is we are going to be doing a partnership with Good Dollar. So on the 5th of July, we're going to be launching the Good Dollar Challenge. That will be going for 4 weeks in total, and there'll be 3 deposits within that. And it's up to you to decide how much Good Dollar that you want to deposit. So you can, yeah, depending on how much you want to play around with, how much you'd like to save, it's your call. There will be some incentives for that. So if you complete the challenge, you will get some extra rewards. There'll also be a leaderboard that you can see yourself climb up. And we can also look at potentially like sending out NFTs and other goodies to the Good Dollar community as well. So definitely check it out on the 5th of July. And yeah, thank you for listening.
Thanks, Rachel. I do have a question. So if I don't make the first deposit on time, I cannot join the pool afterwards. Is that how it works?
Yes, in this version, it does. So you'll need to join before the first deposit round has closed. We are looking at making something that's going to be more flexible and allow people to kind of work a little bit more within their own schedules and their own goals. But for this first iteration, that is how it works.
Thank you. I don't know if anyone has like any questions. If not, just because we're a little bit short on time, we're gonna move to Andres, who is one of our community moderators, that they just threw like a proposal on the forum to renew the work that they are doing. So Andres, if you want to introduce yourself and tell us more about the proposal. Thank you.
Hi everyone. I am Andres Muñoz. I am one of 4 community moderators. Actually, 8 days ago, we launched the proposal in Discord. But today we are planning launch the proposal through Snapchat, and some objectives of the proposal give 12.2 is that the community moderator teams will provide 100 hours of community moderation by week, helping to the community in different channels like Telegram, Good Markets, Discord, Facebook. That is the principal task to do, and we do have the task of bringing to the community support desk to solve issues that he can find in the process of learn and introduce yourself to the wallet community, to the Good Dollar community. Some of the principal change of this new community renewal of community moderation is that we launched the proposal for 6 months in comparison with the 3 months who will be doing the proposal the last year. And it's all. Thank you.
Thanks, Andreas. Like, so I gotta say, like, Andreas is a great example because he doesn't feel like super comfortable with his English, but he still comes to the calls and like talks. So like, big thanks for him for doing it. Let's give him he deserves it. Yeah, you're doing great. Thank you so much, Andreas. He takes care of like the Spanish community, and he does his job with Steve, Christian from Brazil, Steve from Nigeria, and Jose from Mexico, who they couldn't join. So thank you so much for like talking and representation of your team. You're doing great. And I want to move with the.
Okay, thank you.
I just want to say that this moderation team was first nominated by the DAO. They were the first DAO proposal ever done, which was they nominated themselves to be the moderators of the Good Dollar community. They've worked as a team across, you know, three different continents, five different languages, really managing the community in however many different groups. And a great example of how community members have really stepped in and become faces and leaders within the community. And so I'm going to vote for them. I recommend everyone else votes for them. And I think they're a great example to show how community members can turn into contributors through contributing to the DAO in the community. So thank you, Andres.
Thank you very much. We try do all of the best way that we can do, and ever we with good intentions to do a good job. And thanks for all.
Awesome, thanks, Andreas. We're gonna move forward with the community update, but I see Progress, who's our community manager. It's not here, so I'm gonna try to do my best to like quickly summarize what he has told me about it. First of all, he wants to do like an ambassador meetup next week. I'm sure he's gonna be sending more details on the ambassador group about it. And then moving quickly, he wants us to remind her that the Token Engineering Study Group is still live and you can all join. I'm gonna drop the link on their Telegram Telegram group. And also I see like Babette is in this call. Also, Broyes wanted to have a shout out for Babette because he graduated on the top fourth of his class. Babette is like our ambassador from Indonesia. So you're doing like a great job. I don't know if you—
Yay, go Babette, that's awesome, congratulations.
You're also putting on the community recap because we are all proud of you. And then I don't know if there's anyone from the Cameroon team, like Boris wanted to talk about the online conferences with Yellow Card. So I don't know if there's anyone from Cameroon who can step up and like tell us a little bit about it.
Yes, of course. Okay. I can talk about this.
Thank you.
Basically, it's just a conference that we
Did we lost him or it was only me?
We lost him.
Yeah.
It was like right when like Zoom was doing so well, something had to happen. It's all it's all good.
They can.
I think it's on his side.
Yeah.
To look specifically to the currency stuff. So basically that.
Yeah, Frank, I think we have some bronze to hear. I think it's your connection. But maybe we can invite him to the next call. And then we're only like 5 minutes left, but I don't want to forget to like introduce to our community like Mish. Mish is our new like community lead. Communications lead. So Mish, please go ahead, introduce yourself to the community. You're going to do a better job than I do, so.
Hi everyone, it's nice to meet you. I'm Mish and I am the new communications lead, and it's been great listening to everyone's stories. I'm super inspired hearing how everyone's just contributing and just giving it their all, and it's super inspiring. And yeah, I'm definitely excited to be here.
Welcome, Mish. We are excited to have you.
Yeah, we're super excited to have you. And there's like 5 minutes left, so I want to open the floor. If there's anyone who has like any questions, wants to talk about it, you've seen like your English, like it doesn't matter, go for it. We're here to listen to you.
All right. Well, if no one else has anything to add, I'm sure we'll, you know, Frank has been doing, I just want to shout out to Frank because I know he's been doing a bunch of refi meetups. I hear about him from a bunch of other people that I talk to. Every time I talk to someone about Good Dollar in Cameroon, they go, oh yeah, I know Frank. He's doing a bunch of stuff with refi in Douala. So I'm looking forward to getting a handle on whatever he was going to share to us today and sharing it out. And if no one else has anything, and I know there's a lot of members from the Cameroon team on this call, and it's just so awesome to see you guys all here engaged, supporting, really, really, really encouraging. And you guys are actually the inspiration behind the savings challenge and why we prioritized it. So we're really, really eager to, you know, launch it with Halify in the next few weeks and hopefully have some really incredible global saving circles based inspired by the team in Cameroon. So if no one else has anything else to add, and I'll let Mary, sometimes we close these calls with a cool song. I don't know if anyone has one queued up, but that's another way you can contribute to the community call is there's an open call for songs from around the music and global music that we can play both in the intro and the outro. So I'm putting that there. But I just wanted to say what a pleasure it was to have so many great guests come and join us today and showcase their work and how they are building on top of Good Dollar infrastructure to actually advance financial inclusion. And it's really incredible to see. So thank you all for your time. And Mary, I'll let you take it away, but it's just really warmed my heart and made me really excited to see everyone join today.
Thank you everyone for joining. I'm going to drop like a Rosalía song because like some people on the team doesn't know who she is. And I don't know if you know, but like we should all know about her. So I'll take the lead on the song. And like, thank you so much for like joining us today.
Thank you. Bye guys. Ciao.
El que quiero. No me quiere, como quiero, que me quiera y termino la condena. Me divierte, maybe tú eres el que me libera. Y es que hoy es carnaval, yo soy de aquí y tú eres de allá. Lo diré en inglés y me entenderá.
Bye, everyone.
What happened to the song?
Thank you.
Just starting to enjoy.
Technical failure. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Hasta luego. Ciao.
Ciao.
Adios.
Answer me.
See you guys. Bye.
Bye-bye.